Might as well bring these up.
Which is in the Bible, but you want to read a different chapter.
We in Bible quote. Bible quote, like, this is a good example. Just get John 3:16. Now break it down for me.
Have you believed that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
You didn't explain it right.
Are you recording me?
Right,
that's what it is, right? So you're trying to tell me that 3:16, let me re-say it.
I get that. We'll read all of it.
3:16 is, and this is what I'll say first. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, What's his name? Okay, it says Jesus in the Bible.
Exactly.
Now hold on, before you continue. That whosoever believeth shall not perish, but have everlasting life. In my words, I believe that as long as you believe in Jesus, you are saved.
So what happens if they don't believe?
Right.
If they don't believe,
right.
And I don't know. I'm not saying that they're not saved, but I know that they misguided if they don't believe. So if you don't believe in that, then what do you believe in? You know what I mean? So if you don't believe in something, you know. So that's my motto. So what?
We're gonna give you some understanding,
bro. John 3:16. It says
true understanding.
Says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Right.
He just said that.
But actually, you know, the Bible wasn't written in English. It was actually originally written in Greek. And the word for world right there is cosmos, is where you get words like cosmetic surgery. Because the word cosmos means order. That's why cosmetic surgery means to put things on order. So the cosmos is Israel. So this is talking about the nation of Israel. The Lord loves Israel, that he said.
Cosmos, what word?
What? That word's world. For God so loved the cosmos. Okay. That's what the Greek says in the original text.
And cosmos, what again?
Because the Greek don't translate perfectly in English. We ain't got the same kind of words.
Right.
So it's hard to say certain things in English that was said in the Greek.
So what is cosmos again?
So it means the orderly arrangement of things. It means that it's talking about Israel, the nation of Israel. But keep going.
For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved.
That world that she's referring to is only the Israelites. That's it.
We got 1,000 more scriptures
so,
to back
so
that up.
So why is it only pertaining to the Israelites?
Say it again.
Why is it only pertaining to
the Israelites? Because the Israelites is the Lord's people.
Right, but
it's
what
a chosen
about,
nation.
But the Lord accepts everybody.
No, the Lord's an Israelite.
That scripture.
That's not true.
That's not true at all. That's not even the Bible.
Any human being,
no.
If they had a power to accept the Lord, do Christ in their hearts.
That means they're Israelite.
There you go.
Okay, so that's what I'm saying. So everybody has the power to be.
Oh, no. It's still God and not in everybody. What does that say? Romans 10 or something like that?
You got this deal.
I understand, but I'm saying anybody that in their heart, that's what they want, they are, they can't be that.
Right. But keep going though, read the rest of that.
Verse 18. He that believes on him is not condemned, but he that believes not is condemned already.
So whoever don't believe, they're condemned already. And condemned means with damnation. Go ahead.
Because you have my belief in the name of the only begotten Son of God.
Yeah, the name is important. The Son of God's name is Yahweh Shah. It's not Jesus.
So where'd you get that name from?
The Hebrew. Because we know in Hebrew, if you study the Hebrew, then you will know his name is Yahweh Shah.
So how does that pertain to the Greek?
Because the Lord is a Hebrew Israelite. You know what I'm saying? His primary language was Hebrew. Okay? They say that originally the book of Matthew was written in Hebrew. But we don't have any surviving copies to this day. But a lot of our people spoke Greek. Because Greek was the main... Just like today, English is the main language across the world. Even people who ain't from England speak English. You know what I mean? So back in the ancient world, Greek was the top language on the earth. Go ahead.
This is Acts 26 and 13.
Is that pertaining to 316 and how I was wrong?
Yeah. Okay. Acts 26 and 13. At midday, O king, I saw in the way a light from heaven. You know what? You're right. Let me get this first. This is Psalms 147 and 19. He showeth his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. You know who Jacob is, right?
John's brother.
Jacob was the brother of Esau. He was later, his name was later by the children. Now he's the father of the 12 tribes of Israel. Okay, he had many wives. Many wives. I just want one. Okay. Listen, he showeth his word unto Jacob.
He showed his word unto Jacob. That's us, the children of Israel.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He hath not dealt so with any nation.
That goes with the prophecies too.
Read the scriptures here.
All them prophecies written about the Lord in the Old Testament. Because you know he was written about in the Old Testament, right? The Messiah. He said, you know, you're going to the Messiah when we come one day. Their prophecies was only given to Israel. They was written by Israelite prophets and Israelite scribes. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know how it was wrong about
this. Let me finish this. We have not dealt so with any nation.
Don't pick me up, dude. I gotta talk to you.
Stay right there.
And as for his judgments, they have not known them.
Yeah, because you see the Edomites, one of the rich white people in the world, they don't know the judgments of the Lord. Because they're not following the laws of the Lord out here.
Okay. You know what I'm saying? How am I wrong? One more time. How am I wrong?
Well, you think... your mind, if the Lord is for everybody, as long as they, you know, because a lot of people confess, devils confess that they love the Lord.
How can you determine? Only the Lord knows.
You're right.
And you're trying to tell me that if a person did once believe, that's the reason you are here. So a person once believed that the Lord didn't exist or he believed in demons or whatever, then one day he's changed. You're trying to tell me, you said he was once condemned, always condemned, but you said,
yeah, of course.
I believe that if once somebody, if they get the knowledge and they decide to change their way of life, then what's that?
The Lord's elect was chosen before the earth was created, according to the Bible.
Okay, but what if they was misguided? What if their parents talked about the earth?
That was how we grew up. Yeah, that's what we tell people to repent.
Right, that's what
because the ones the Lord already chose, they're going to automatically repent.
So I wasn't really wrong. You didn't say that.
You still think that the Lord is coming. For example,
what does that mean? I said, if you confess and say that you believe in Jesus Christ, that you are saved, that's what the scriptures say.
Right.
All I'm saying is, you said that that's wrong.
His name isn't Jesus Christ.
Okay, that's what everybody knows.
Well, everybody's wrong.
That's what that says.
If I call you by the other name, you're going to respond?
That's what that says.
Right. If I called you by another name, if I called you by another name, you would respond.
No, but what I'm saying is, as long as we are referring to the same person, it's okay.
Well, we're not referring to the same person.
It is. When I get on my knees and I pray to Jesus or God, I'm praying.
When they say Jesus, that image pops in their mind.
Right.
Scripture says, make no mention of no other God's name. That's another God.
Oh, that's a bad scripture.
Jesus is a Negro, and not a white
man. That's right, according to the Bible. That's a false image. That's the image they deceived the whole world with.
Well, he wasn't. He was. They said it was.
The scriptures say he got hair like wool.
Right. His skin was fair because he's from the Middle East. Like, of course, everybody over there, their So ain't no white people over there.
Yeah, that's actually where the white
now,
man is from.
Now, because they traveled, right? I'm talking that's about where he's from. At that time, in Bible time.
That's where the white man
is. All them people was the same.
The white man is from that area. Esau, the Edomites, the white man, and they're from that area. They're from the desert region. Actually, the hottest region of all of them.
Remember I told Jacob's brother, Esau?
That's probably why he hid out in caves and shit. You know what I mean? Up in the caves of Mount Seir, which is modern-day Jordan. And that's where he's from. Hey, get that second Ezra. That breaks it down beautifully about the world. You know what I mean?
Second Ezra 6 and And after these, Adam also whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures, of him came we all, and the people also whom thou hast chosen. All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sake.
Yes, sir, we all come from Adam, okay? All the nations, all the different nations come from Adam, you know what I mean? But the Lord made the world for Israel's sake, just like this scripture right here says. The world was created for us. Go ahead.
And for the other people which also came of Adam, thou hast said that they are nothing.
So the other people that come from Adam, the Hamites, the Edomites, okay, all these different heathen nations, all them the Muslims, them Ishmaelites, okay, those are heathens. They ain't got nothing to do with us. They got nothing to do with the promise. Go ahead.
Be likened unto spittle, and have likened the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
Yeah, so the Lord said to other heathen nations, they like spit unto us. Okay, because the earth was created for Israel. That's why the Lord said, God so loved the world. But if you can't get it, you can't get it. We're not concerned.
That's true. That's the Spirit said that. She kept saying, it says Jesus. And then also in the scripture how it says that. These scriptures is also a stumbling block,
yeah.
You know, to most people, you know?
When you start reading the laws in the Bible, ain't nobody trying to hear all them laws in the Bible. They ain't trying to hear that you can't eat no pork. They ain't trying to hear that. They ain't trying to hear that you got to keep the Sabbath. They ain't trying to hear that. Just like they ain't trying to hear the truth about John 3:16. They ain't trying to hear it.
They got too much love in their belly.
But the ones that's going here, they're going here. Might as well just stay on Israel. I got one.
Just Israel.
Here go one. Matthew 1:21.
Hallelujah.
And she shall bring forth a son, and that shall call his name Yahweh Shai, for he shall save his people from their sins. And so who's the Lord's people? You can read it. It got a genealogy right here. It says the book of the generation of Yahweh Shai Mashiach, the son of David, the son of Abraham. David was from the tribe of Judah. You know what I mean? David wasn't no heathen. The Lord is a direct descendant of King David. He's an heir to the throne of Israel. And that's why when they crucified the Lord, they put the King of the Jews on that. Pontius Pilate wrote King of the Jews on there. Because he was from the tribe of Judah. He wrote in Latin, Greek, and Hebrew, which proves the Lord spoke Hebrew. You know what I mean?
Here you go. 2 Ezra 3:16. And unto him thou gavest Isaac, and unto Isaac also thou gavest Jacob and Esau. As for Jacob, thou didst choose him to thee, and put by Esau, and so Jacob became a great multitude.
Yeah, because Esau didn't get the promise. He didn't get the blessing.
You know, Esau ain't
like the love you know. Really, when you look at it, I mean, our blessing was like peace and love, right? And Jacob's blessing was, you know, we're the kings of the earth. What's the scripture say? In Isaiah 2, in the kingdom, all nations will go to us and get the law. But that was Esau's blessing was death and destruction. He was going to rule the earth by the sword. And you can say that's why Esau is red, the color of blood. Because he represents blood and death and everything wicked in the earth. And that's who's controlling the earth today. That's why you see all this wicked shit out here, man. This wicked ass government. Now everybody crying about Donald Trump. Don't nobody want to hear it. You know what know what I mean? He's trying to bring that hammer down on this dude. You already had it. You already said it. He's going to take the feds in Chicago. What are they going to do with that? They going to shut that shit down.
Baby, my man.
Go ahead.
Number 24.
That he has said, which heard the words of God and knew the knowledge of the Most High, which saw the vision of the Almighty falling into a trance by having his eyes open. I shall see him, but not now. I shall behold him, but not now. There shall come a star out of Jacob, and a scepter shall rise out of Israel, and shall smite upon his Moab, and restore all his children,
except. Oh, that's talking about the Lord. That's talking about Yahweh Shai. He's the king of Israel. And it said he going to smash them heathens, bro. The Lord said, huh?
He called them destroy the Gentiles.
Yeah.
And Edom shall be a possession.
S-E-I-R? Yeah, Mount Seir. That's Esau's home country.
Number 24:18 again. Edom shall be possession. Seir also shall be possession for his enemies. And Israel shall be made. Out of Jacob shall come he that shall have dominion, and shall destroy him that remaineth of the city.
Yeah, so right, all this shit, these devils, they ruin over us right now. It's all temporary. Hey. But soon they lose their power, we taking over the earth. That's what's going to happen. It's all these little cops and all these little judges. And all these motherfucking politicians, their rulership is only for a short time. See what I'm saying? The Lord gave them a little time to rule, but then it's going to be over. Then we're going to be ruled. Go ahead.
And when he looked on Amalek, he took up his parable and said, Amalek was the first of the nations, but his latter end shall be that he shall perish forever.
The first of the nations, meaning like the head. You know what I'm saying? Because in that Amalek running shit, he's running the earth right now. And Amalek is the head tribe of the Edomites, because the Edomites had multiple tribes just like Israel. I think they had, what, like 11 tribes? Because Esau is like a counterfeit Israel, you know what I mean? I got to screw the back door.
This is Isaiah 47:1. Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground, there is no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans.
Yeah, the daughter of Babylon right now, that's talking about America. America's Babylon, okay? America's Babylon, the city of great confusion. Because there ain't nothing but confusion out here. Go ahead.
For thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. Take the millstone.
Oh yeah, because they say America's like they compare America to a beautiful woman, Lady Liberty. They call her Lady Liberty. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but Kyle Shire referred to that bitch as a whore.
A whore. That's right. Because America's that you read about that great whore in the book of Revelation, that's talking about America. They've committed all kind of whoredoms in the earth. Go ahead.
And grind mill, uncover thy locks. Make bare the leg. Uncover the thigh, pass over the rivers. Thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen. And that's especially through the internet, man. Those other nations that can't come here, they see the faggots strolling, you know. They hear about the fucking passing the laws, so the LGBT shit, cops protecting them, you know. They see the shame.
They'll lock you up for some bullshit. But the same court system to locking you up allows faggots get married. They getting paid off. They accepting bribes. They getting blackmailed because they engaged in child pornography. That's why that thing about Pizzagate. You see that thing about Pizzagate was in the news, and it was exposing how all these politicians are engaged in child molestation. They caught up in child molestation ring. And they go to these little secret child molestation parties, where they get high on drugs and torture children. That's what all these politicians are doing. You can't get into office unless you molest the children. That's the way this country works. And that's why they got butt-naked statues in front of the state house right there. They got little naked statues of naked children right in front of the state house. So you can't say we lying. We know what we talking about. This is Satan's kingdom. Go ahead.
Like nakedness shall be uncovered, yea. Like shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance and I will not meet thee as a man.
So the Lord ain't coming back as no man. He coming back in his full power and glory. With them holy hosts and angels. He gonna destroy all this shit. Every last one of these buildings is gonna be destroyed. The state house, the Lord is gonna destroy the state house. He's gonna destroy all this shit. All these cars, they all gonna be destroyed. All these people out here running their mouth, the Lord's gonna destroy them, bro. Anybody that came up against the word of the Lord, they're gonna be destroyed.
Hey, what happened after Ezra saw after the Lord destroyed shit? And afterwards what he saw was only dust and the smell of smoke.
Pulverized, what?
Everything is vaporized.
Yeah.
Everything.
What you mean was happening?
It's gonna be beautiful, man. We're gonna be praising the Lord today. We're gonna be praising God goddamn Christ and Jesus, man.
Hell no.
No.
He gonna automatically put it in our spirit so we speak in the proper Hebrew. We got to sing this Revelation say, when we get beamed up, we're going to be singing the song of Moses. The song of Moses was not written in English. You know what I'm saying? But we're going to be singing the Hebrew. Yeah, singing. You imagine celebrating speaking English? That's crazy.
That's why two-thirds can't make it, man. Let me continue on.
I'll show you why two-thirds
can't. As for our Redeemer, the Lord of hosts is his name. The Holy One of Israel.
The Holy One of Israel. Not the whole earth.
That name will keep coming up. Sit thou silent and get thee into darkness of dark like a Chaldeans. Thou shalt no more be called the Lady of Kingdoms.
Yeah, so America ain't going to be no more the Lady of Kingdoms. America's going to be destroyed. That's all there is to it. It's got to be destroyed. That's the only way we're going to be free. Is when the Lord comes back and destroys all this shit. And then we're going to be free.
You know, something going to make you free then?
That Trump shit. I praise the Lord for that, actually.
Yeah, that's a beautiful thing. It really is. That's beautiful.
That's some amazing shit.
Yeah. It really is.
It's amazing.
And how he got everybody divided.
Yeah, it's totally divided.
Woo, man.
It's divided right down the damn middle.
And they got posting all these pictures and newspapers and news articles and magazines with Trump's face with a target on it.
But here it is. You know, the whole time Trump was running for president, he said Hillary for prison. He gonna lock up Hillary. Soon as he gets elected, oh, the Clintons are great people. Man, he part of the same club that Obama was part of. He part of the same club that the Clintons was part of. They all part of the same shit. Ain't none of these politicians your friend. None of them. Just backed up for years.
I was wroth with my people. I have polluted my inheritance and given them into thy hand. Thou didst show them no mercy.
Yeah, Esau ain't showing us no mercy. He show you no mercy. I found out that out of the hard way. Go ahead. You escape one trap, you fall in another trap.
Right.
Out here.
Right. You finish, you pay off one bill.
You gotta know, you can't. It's a never-ending debt. You know what I mean? You always owe this devil some money. He want to get every last dollar in your pocket, man. Fucking devil, man. Y'all happy with this shit out here? If you happy in America, something's fucking wrong with you, man. Something's fucked up in your head if you like this country. You just fucked in the head.
Thou didst show them no mercy upon the ancient as thou very heavily laid thy yoke.
They'll shoot an old man, an old lady. They don't care. They'll shoot your dog. Cops love shooting dogs, too. That's one of their specialities. Go in your house, shoot your dog, shoot your little girl. That's how they roll it. And then everybody likes it. That y'all good with it. Cause real, if y'all had any sense, y'all be over here with us. You know what I'm saying? If you had any sense at all, you will be over here with us. Go ahead.
If thou sayest, I shall be a lady forever. So thou didst not lay these things to thy heart, neither didst remember the latter end of them.
Right, they ain't remembering none of the statutes, none of the commandments. In America, there ain't no Sabbath. It's legal. A woman can commit adultery in America with no punishment. That's one of the Ten Commandments. Adultery is one of the Ten Commandments. In America, you're allowed to commit adultery. It's encouraged. It's part of...
Men too, man.
Yeah,
same
men.
Shit. Commit adultery with no punishment.
Yep, they do.
Shit.
That's one of the Ten Commandments.
Nicole Simpson and dude, what's his name, that got caught, that got killed with him?
Yeah.
That was just a one-off case, man. Huh?
They got lucky.
Yeah.
Shit. The Lord showed OJ a little love until he fucked him up again.
Yeah, he didn't thank the Lord.
That's what happened. He wasn't thanking the Lord, right?
He didn't thank the Lord. He thanked Jesus.
Thank Jesus. I praise the Lord when he fucks me up, bro.
Jesus. Praise the Lord. He said a new type of weed.
That little thing.
She picked it on something.
Yeah, micro.
She picked it on something.
The plant is going to grow. She's going to have a weed plant.
Let me continue on. Therefore, hear now this, thou that are given to pleasures.
Given, oh, that's America, bro. This whole country, that's how it operates. It's all about pleasure. You know, activating your pleasure center.
But that was a... What's Leonard used to say to us all the time?
Oh, yeah.
Remember, he used to always say, go have fun.
Yeah, go have fun. He's like, y'all keep talking about all this gloom and doom. Go have fun.
Just have fun.
Hey, it's impossible to have fun out here. How you going to have fun when you got the damn devil on your ass 24-7? Right down the street, we'll get a cop fucking with you. Taking all your shit, going up inside your pockets. Go ahead.
Yeah,
they're gonna crack you upside the head and lock you up.
Who speaks like that, man? Let's go have fun. Let's just have fun. Children speaks that way, you know? And that's the state of mind these men are in. They just child state of mind.
You can't have fun out here. There's nothing fun about this shit.
Are you right? Like you said, we oppressed. You know, every time we turn our back, it was goddamn, I fucked up. It was a goddamn devil, you know, oppressing the shit out of you. You know what I'm saying? So I can't relax. You know,
you can't relax.
You can't.
And then you got worried about our own people fucking robbing us.
Oh, Jack Williams.
You can't, you know, you got to watch what streets you walking down. You bunch of wicked ass people, man.
I fuck everybody, no privacy, you can't go in the backyard.
That's scripture too, because the Lord said, woman to them that put house to house, something like that, you know. Like,
yeah.
House to house. And I'm talking about you walk outside, you right, you can see right in the neighbor's house.
Yeah, no privacy.
You can hear them.
No privacy.
You can fuck, man.
But you got your boy, oh, that's another thing about Donald Trump. He said Edward Snowden should be executed. And Edward Snowden is the one that came out and told you the government was recording all your phone calls. They keeping all your emails. And every call you make is being recorded.
Y'all watch that movie yet?
What is it?
Snowden.
Nah,
I ain't watched it yet.
I keep
Brother said it was bad, man.
Yeah, I need to watch that.
Yeah, I need to get myself Snowden.
But they think Trump's a good guy. He said fucking Snowden should be executed.
And wait a minute. Who did the thing with Chelsea Manning?
Yeah, WikiLeaks and all that.
Yeah, but wasn't it Obama that lessened his charge?
Oh, it was, yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking that was Trump.
Something like that.
I don't think Trump was with
it. It was Obama.
Yeah, Trump ain't with it. Pardons before he left.
Trump's a dirty bastard. he's with all the dirty shit. He said he's okay to torture people, man. That dude's whacked in his head, man.
Yeah.
But that's good, though. That's good. Because he going to torture some people. Y'all going to find out the hard way.
He said that to Snowden. Not much for us.
Exactly. And he did nothing wrong. You know what I mean? Oh, he going to set up some attacks. They going to find an excuse to lock that travel ban down. They going to have some attacks.
They're going to create one, yeah.
They going to create something.
Yeah, we hope so, man. We hope. Through prayer, we hope.
We already know. I mean, there's a new government staged terrorist attack like every couple of weeks. We had one here in Columbus down at OSU. You know what I mean? So they going to be more and more. Yeah, we need that big
one. That's going to really put the people up. Shut the people up and have them watching the television like, oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Have them stuck on stupid like 9-11.
Right, right. And give them 10 or something.
Oh, that's another thing too, like Trump banning everybody from traveling from the Muslim countries. How come he didn't ban people from Saudi Arabia? You know what I mean?
He has business there.
Afghanistan.
Oh, he got, exactly. I mean, common sense, right? But that's where all the terrorists are from, in Saudi Arabia.
That's where 98% of all the 9/11 hijackers were from.
That's what I'm saying. It's all bullshit. People buy into this bullshit every 4 years, man. They buy into a new clown that they put their trust in. Go ahead.
Therefore, hear now this, thou that art given to pleasure, that dwellest carelessly, that sayest in thy heart, I am, and none else beside me. I shall not sit as a widow, neither shall I know the loss of children. But
that's what they be thinking, like America's untouchable. That's how they feel. If I can't know when they defeat America.
John Gotti said the same thing.
Where's he at?
They locked the fuck up. He only see an hour of sunlight. Once a week?
That's fucked up too, locking people up like that. And somebody, this, a crime that was so bad, just kill him. Just fucking kill him. You gonna, that's because Esau's a sick fuck. And he gets pleasure out of torturing people. You know what I mean? That's why he gets pleasure out of, these politicians get pleasure out of raping little boys and little children. And torturing them, burn them with soldering iron. You hear the stories that come out.
Sick, sadistic shit. But these two things shall come to thee in a moment, in one day, the loss of children and widowhood. They shall come upon thee in their perfection.
Also, yeah, the Lord gonna do Esau's children worse than he did the Egyptian children. Back in the Exodus, how he killed the firstborn son, there's gonna be a whole lot more death than that.
Canaanites, how they did ever destroy the temple of the Lord. Still doing to them.
Yeah.
You know? Filthy ass. See motherfuckers eating flies and shit.
Yeah, because the Canaanites were famous for being cannibals, yeah, too.
Motherfuckers were so weak, the flies, they can't get stupid.
Yeah, you know? they're so malnourished.
They're fucking them up, man. Fucking Canaanites. They shall come upon thee in their perfection for the multitude of thy sorceries and for the great abundance of thy enchantments.
Yeah, we seen some of them sorceries last night in the Super Bowl with that Lady Gaga shit. Man, every year the Super Bowl, they got some kind of satanic Super Bowl halftime show. You know what I mean? Do some little ritual, put the people in the dark. And that whole Super Bowl was all fixed. All sports are fixed. That game last night was fixed. They gonna throw a flag on the next to last play in the game. That's all bullshit. Football's all bullshit. Basketball's all bullshit. It's all fake. That's just about as real as the WWE. Y'all live in La La Land out here. Hey, but they said the Vegas numbers was the highest ever last night. You know what I mean? Vegas made record numbers last night. You see they're trying to get the Raiders to go to Vegas.
For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness. Thou hast said none sees me.
Yeah, they don't think nobody see when they out there in a Freemason temple. Hey, there's a Freemasonic temple right down the street on, was that, 3rd? They all over the place. There's one right behind us. What am I talking about? That's the main temple. You know what I mean? That's a temple. That's not the state house. That's a temple. That's a temple to Jupiter. Just like the ancient Romans built. That's an ancient Roman temple right there. Might as well just get it on camera. Can we see it? Go ahead, read that. If I even get that. Go ahead.
For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness. Thou hast said none sinned, thy wisdom and thy knowledge. They have perverted thee.
Right, they got that wisdom and the knowledge. That's why all the food you eating from the store, unless you can afford to buy organic, it's all GMO. You got all kind of deadly pesticides in the food. It's messing us up, giving us cancer. You wonder why everybody dropping dead at the age 50 now, you know what I'm saying? Everybody walk around, everybody's grotesquely obese. I ain't never seen so many obese people in my life. That's because they eating that unhealthy ass food. And they got no nutrition in it. All the food in the stores have been robbed in this nutrition. So you gotta eat and eat and eat to get just a little something, you know what I mean? Go ahead.
Sick.
Yeah, we're all sick out here. We eating this fucked up food.
Therefore shall evil come upon thee. Thou shalt not know from whence it riseth, and mischief shall fall upon thee.
You're right, so that evil, that the evil day is coming soon. And y'all gonna witness that evil day with your own eyes. You're gonna see it.
Y'all gonna be walking up here. He do got everybody to sleep like this motherfucker really can make this place great again. Motherfuckers don't mind waking up to go to work now, you know, they mind they got something to look forward to. How we were saying that, what the hell is the Most High gonna do, you know, to flip this shit? And that's
because they over there like, whew, it's all over.
That's just as this is that right there.
And shit ain't changed. Everything's the same.
Therefore shall evil come upon thee. Thou shalt not know from whence it rises.
And we're going to pray to the Lord that they bring the draft back, the military draft.
That draft's coming.
Because they finna go into Iran. If you a young man, about what, age 20 to 40. Sorry for you.
It's younger than that.
Trump's
18,
gonna
be a lot younger than that.
18, you know, 17.
Women too.
Women. Oh, yeah. Women. Y'all got equal rights now.
Yeah, women fighting on the front line now.
Yeah, there you go. Show with equality.
Women are Marines now.
Oh, so, shit.
What the Marines be hollering now?
Semper Fi.
The Marines.
Semper Fi.
Rich is getting the tattoo, Marine tattoo.
Got the bulldog and shit.
What is the mark of the beast? It's a microchip. It's an actual physical implant that's going to be implanted up inside of you. It's already going on.
Hey, I just seen something in the news. They said only 40, like, not even 50% of people use actual cash in the grocery store. Most everybody using debit cards now.
Cards. Yeah, it's a problem. It's all scripture. It's all the Bible.
That's some curses the Lord put on the Israelites, the children of Israel, for not following the commandments. So now,
the whole situation,
I get,
the Lord's going to cause cashless society. Okay? You know, it's already in works right now. Everybody using debit cards and so on, okay? But something's going to happen. They're going to delete all cash. I don't give a fuck. These devils don't care if you got $1 million in your backyard buried. You know what I mean? You're only going to get like 10% of that $1 million if you take it to a bank. But they're going to delete all cash. I mean, it's going to be a cashless society. And that's when this is going to come into play. Okay? And it's going to happen because it's happening now. You know? But it's going to cut that point. It's coming where it's going to be, you ain't going to have no choice but to get the chip.
Most people gonna beg for it, actually.
They're right.
They gonna
beg. Fighting in line, get in front of four fuckers to get that chip.
Especially when they want to get their EBTs. Cause
so what's the thing about slavery?
It's all curses, man. It's mentioned in the Bible. We the Israelites.
I get Revelation 13.
We the Israelites. So the Lord punished us and we went through that. Right. That was the Lord's goal. You know?
Oh, we got a scripture.
Revelation 13:9, if a man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth.
Oh,
I'm
looking.
It's all the same. Yeah, that's the spirit, ain't it?
Right.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. So there's got to be retribution. There got to be payback for that, bro.
The same devils that put us in slavery, they got to go into slavery.
Now, anybody eat a Ruby Tuesdays, man?
He that filleth with the sword must be killed with the sword. There is the patience and the faith of the saints.
There's the patience and the faith of the saints to put these motherfuckers that put us into captivity. And that's the Lord's. The Lord is with them. You know? The Lord, they tell you to put them, actually, he's a man of war. You know, he ain't no soft-spoken faggot that these motherfuckers trying to portray him as. Going around handing out chocolate kisses and flowers, you know, and talking, speaking on the phone. The Lord was rough, man.
The Lord come. The Lord coming with that vengeance.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, what they do? Don't take the shit and take the chick and get destroyed. You know what I'm saying? That's like. Revelation 14.
Listen, man, the time is coming. People gonna stalk. Everybody gonna start
Trump,
starving.
Trump already gonna cut off the welfare and everything.
Oh, yeah.
They say he's gonna cut it off.
This is all by design, man. These people gonna starve us out. So their solution is this. They can come. This is the solution we have. You can chip so you can eat. Because we're gonna start starving. Water, the food, ain't gonna be no McDonald's. The grocery stores, the shelves gonna be empty. And this is all gonna happen quick. So when this comes, when this time comes, you gotta have that faith, man, that strength. Through this Bible, that's why we out here.
In Revelation 14 and 9, and the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if a man worship the beast in his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand.
In his forehead and his hand, and mention in his forehead and his hand, because they got technology for the implant force, all kind of chips on, you know, that controls. Hell, they got chips implanting people, they can control limbs, you know,
they
phones,
kill you with
television.
They give you a heart attack.
Yep. So, receive the mark. Go ahead, bro.
Saying shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation.
Wrath. Anger.
Ooh. He shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb.
And that fire.
You're already warning the people to get right with the Lord. You're already warning the people to get right with the Lord. So when the time comes, you know, hey, you've already told everyone. You know? So everybody's going to go and rush and get the chip or, you know, whatever, man. Everyone's going to be destroyed. You call Jesus, man, man.
They said they gonna pray, but that he will not hear them.
With fire and brimstone, man.
That's the missiles.
Oh, man.
And we know the missiles. I just read an article today said Iran could shoot on a missile on Israel and get there in 17 minutes.
Shoot.
17 minutes.
Because they use, Iran use solid fuel and liquid fuel. So they got the advanced ship. They can either use either one.
They more advanced than they letting on.
Yeah, way more advanced. You remember how we used to talk about the earthquake that was happening in Iran?
Yeah.
Earthquakes was missiles they was testing, man. That's good, man.
So, who is the people who are running the
same? The Israelites.
The elect. The elect. Not everybody, but the elect of Israel.
Yeah, because they understand that there are many terrorists in Israel who are terrorizing the Palestinians.
Yeah, the so-called Jews, they're not Jews. They're the terrorists.
Yeah, but they're Israelis.
They're Israelis. They're not.
See, you notice Israeli isn't in the body.
Yes.
Israelis.
So, you guys recognize that they are terrorizing Palestinians.
Oh, Israelis is devils, man.
Yeah, they're devils.
That's the devils, man. That's the head devil tribe, which you were talking about earlier.
Get Revelation 2.
Yeah, that's the head devil tribe.
Is they the ones who you think owns Huntington Bank?
Because people honestly believe that just because they're Israelis, they are the chosen people.
No, they ain't the chosen people.
They're not Israelites. They're Edomites.
You know what an imposter is, though?
Imposter, yeah.
They're imposters.
I hope it's
true. Everybody wants to be the chosen nation. Because they know the benefits of being the chosen nation.
I think it's 25 times. But I know that you all these guys are supposed to be married.
Hold on, bro.
Where are those people? Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
How do you get this out? Did he say he was
the Lord? That nigga to hear the word. Got him. Man, that's beautiful when that happens.
What happened?
That happens all the time. They just despise hearing the word, man. Hey, I didn't show these. I didn't see one dude say that. Give him any bus. Like, wow, what? Just got on any bus just to go down the street, man. Or go somewhere else for another bus stop.
What the fuck is wrong with these people?
They stupid. Stupid, man.
They love being slaves. That's what the scripture says. Israel, he a homeborn slave. He's just like a well-trained dog. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? They're like well-trained dog. They tell you to sit, your ass sits. You
what's
know what I'm saying?
He sure ain't like the other ones. You just stick to your business.
That's how he said that, but all of Israel is Israel. Here you go. This is Hosea 4 and 5. Therefore shall thou fall in the day, and the prophet also shall fall with thee in the night, and I will destroy thy mother. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee.
And you'll see all people destroyed. That's why you go in our neighborhoods. What do you see? Everyone trash. Streets is just trash. Houses all fucked up, dirty. You don't even want to go into some of these people's houses, man.
shit. He saw about taking out the power, man. He bring people's house. Bring his houses out, man. They didn't even have the phone game to be living in.
Nope. Yeah, what is that? You gotta pay rent. Every last dollar you get at work goes to what? Rent and going back to work. Rent high as fuck. You gotta pay what? $600 a month for some old beat up ass shit though. In the floor that you did. Got roaches.
That's funny, man.
They are on no kind of level to even say no, man.
Yep, they're stupid.
I hate these people. You know, everybody's called on the name of the Lord, we'd be the hell out of here, bro. If everybody just stopped what the hell they was doing and came over here and was doing what we did, it'd be over. You know what I mean?
Here in the 90s, man, my dumb ass actually thought these niggas couldn't get away. I actually thought that back then. I was thinking, I knew they was what the shit then, you know. But I honestly thought they couldn't get no worse.
It's gonna get worse.
Yeah, this is terrible. This is pretty much a lawless society. Lawless society. Lawless society being
lawless against the Bible. Right.
Lawless society under the
But you get, they'll punish you for fucking breaking his laws, you know what I mean? It's all bullshit ass laws.
Hey, y'all see their children, the black people isn't like the terrorists. Esau got great hair.
I thought he was dead.
Yeah,
he is dead.
Motherfucker, I actually made a video of how
to
put my ass in
the camera. Oh, you talking about that one. That, never mind, I'm getting confused with somebody else. Right. Yeah, he had them videos where he's so-called summoning up UFOs. He was famous. That's the first time I've heard him too. I seen it on YouTube back in like 2007. I heard it on that. Because he was hanging out with some kind of Arab motherfucker or something.
I saw him with the news people.
Yeah, I seen the news people too, but he was on some kind of Arab channel.
This is back to the scripture. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee.
And you can see that's why we like this, because y'all rejected the Lord. And you can see that you rejected. And none of y'all got shit. Ain't none of y'all doing shit. You know what I mean? You got another.
Thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of thy power. I will also forget thy chains. As they were increased, so they sinned against me. Therefore, I change their heart into shame. They eat of sin of my people, and they set their heart on iniquity.
That's what Israel does. They set their hearts on their iniquity. All they're thinking about is committing adultery, being a faggot. That's why people be talking shit. We'll be out here. They ain't got no but wickedness on their mind. They ain't no good in it at all. They no good.
From a personal place, bro. This is different strands of shit. Nope. Who's my tape? I brought that tape.
Oh, shit.
So, when will soon?
Man, you just look at this shit out here. It just makes you sick to your stomach just looking at this shit. These people are good. It's like some kind of a fucking nightmare.
It's, Luke 19:41. It says, and when he was come over, he beheld the city, and wept over it, saying, if thou hast known even thou, at least in that day, the things which belong to thy peace, but now they are hidden from thine eyes, the day shall come upon thee that thy enemy shall cast a trick upon thee, and cast it down about thee. They shall lay thee down and give you the ground with thy children and fish. They shall not leave if thee one stone upon the earth, because thou doest not to turn about it. That they got all this talent and shit, but they don't want to pray how this shot.
I got a scripture for this.
It's just like, man, who's making this song to see how this shot? This song would be like perfect.
That'd be dope.
You gotta put the lyrics into a song and shit. You can't even relax and turn the song on and just listen to it. You gotta feel it.
I got a scripture to back you up. This is Colossians 3:16. Let the word Yahawashah dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of Yahawashah, giving thanks to Yahweh and the Father by him. So, yeah, like you said, you make a song, the whole song, you're supposed to be praising the Lord in the song. Praising the devil. That'll work too. You know what I'm saying?
They keep coming out more new and new ones, man. You know, my stupid ass sister was being interviewed about a few of them. She was actually in an interview for a reality show. Black people living in farms. You know, black people living in the country. This is just recent. She probably was sucking out of the pants and getting that popular time.
This shit gotta go, man.
All this silly, foolish shit up on the power. Here we ain't living in no time of fucking foolishness. For every season, you know, for every time there's a season, they're trumpeting, he's signing all kinds of things. People are still fucking relaxed.
He making moves, he making big moves.
Serious chess moves, man.
With quick, too, with quick. They say he only sleep 4 hours a night. Hey, get that scripture. I'll look for it. Here's a scripture to say that. Yeah, his eyes are always bloodshot red.
Oh,
yeah. You know what I mean?
Remember when Obama came to office, he had a pink red purple lips.
Yeah.
He told everybody to put it in the glass and stop that shit out. He cut that shit out. Nigga had crackhead lips, man.
Hey, that's what was that one dude that said he was sniffing, smoking crack with Obama?
Larry Sinclair.
Yeah, because he said, I was sniffing coke, but he said Obama didn't like coke. He liked crack.
Yeah, yeah. And he said, while he blowing with me,
yeah.
I be doing my thing, and while I'm doing it to him, he's doing it. there was multiple videos from Larry Sinclair.
He testified before.
Yeah, y'all knew what since they was seeing out the state board. A long one of these.
What up?
With his hood down.
Town, man, coming back talking, man, any town, man. the strength.
I can't go clubbing no more.
I'm going to go clubbing, period. You'll never catch me in a club. Never catch me in a club.
I feel like I caught you in a club twice.
You know? See, I'll run into a bar every once in a while, but you'll never see me in a club. In them clubs, all kind of hell pops off every once in a while. There's all, actually every fucking weekend in clubs, man, there's always something happening, man.
I'm talking about like the white clubs.
The white clubs?
Yeah, the white clubs.
I ain't going to the white club either.
Oh, the white clubs.
I'm going for the bartender, put all kinds of shit.
I didn't go there for the drinks, I just went there to dance.
You can dance.
I just said, no, I can't. I found this out this weekend.
Remind me, put your ass in my club. She knows me, she knows me. Oh man, where we at? Where we at? Where we at?
I'll look for myself.
That's what we was gonna talk about. How they put foolishness up on a pedestal.
So, is there like a short guy who always runs with the great stranger?
Say it again?
Is there like a short guy like who always runs with the great stranger?
Oh,
Like, always have a mean look on his face, kind of like.
What are you talking about, Jonathan?
He said, Ecclesiastes 10 and 6. Folly is set in great dignity, and the rich sit in the low place.
Folly is set in great dignity, right.
So the rich sit in low places.
You see all these fools that running shit, politicians, they always getting caught being child molesters, fucking devil worshippers. Yeah, they came out with a WikiLeaks that said that John Podesta do one revisers, that they was doing something called, what they call soup, spirit soup. When they was putting blood and nut into the paint and making paintings with blood and nut and shit.
It ain't no mop, people.
No, it ain't mop. They get real blood and nuts and sperm. Piss, they shit in and piss in it too. They make painting. You know they was eating it too.
Mixing all together.
Mixing it all together and they make a painting out of it. Hey, that, Hillary Clinton, she was on record.
What is y'all, bro? The same people that be down here?
What's that again?
Israelites?
Yeah, we Israelites. We the same ones as the ones in the purple or red even.
What's the difference?
Yeah, we got the truth.
So they don't have the truth?
No.
They know a few scriptures. That's about it.
That's it. But they don't have the truth. They don't have the spirit of prophecy in it. Period.
That's what's so crazy about this stuff. Like, imagine y'all talking about them, but they're out here doing the same thing y'all doing.
Well, what they ain't doing the same thing as us.
No,
they're not doing the same thing. It appears that they are, but you stop and listen. They're not doing the same thing. You know?
Once again, who's saying they wrong and who's saying
they're
right?
We saying they're wrong. Because we're the real men of the Lord. We're the prophets of the Lord.
Who said that, though?
Because they don't come under the name of the Yahweh Shemat Yahushua. They may utter it out every long once in a while. They call on Christ.
They call on Christ. Him for 6 weeks.
But what I'm saying is, though, who is telling y'all that y'all right, though?
The Lord, the Spirit. The Spirit's telling
you. The same thing with them, though. It's one of them things that you can go back and forth with. You can't say somebody else. What they believe in is wrong.
At the end of the day, we're going to find out.
We can only give you another example, too, if they were around.
Because
they're not pushing this. They don't push this.
They mock that and make fun of it. Right. They make fun of the Lord's Hebrew name. The news ain't right.
And they don't in the winter neither.
And actually, their leader, Nathaniel, his name is Nathaniel, he's a detective for the NYPD. So you can just throw that. Them guys are gone. They out of there.
So you got to have 100% truth, not some.
And you can't.
When they out here, why don't you put them in their place?
We did. They run. They pack up and leave.
They pack up and leave.
Because they know we got cameras to record everything.
They all about that paper.
Right.
At the end of the day, they about getting that money.
Right.
We ain't about that. We about the truth.
We come to give you the truth whether you like it or not.
They ain't no different than Creflo Dollar and T.D. Jakes. You know what I mean?
Eddie Longstroke.
He out of there now.
Eddie Longstroke.
Hey, it's scripture for you. Ain't let you fuck up. Hey, it's scripture for you.
Let's give you one scripture.
First John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are God. Because many false prophets are going out into the world.
So you gotta know the doctrine, man, but understand that they're pushing the right thing or the wrong thing, you know what I'm saying? We build season then, so we can just go up and do it. We already know they ain't coming from it, you know?
We're trying to Old Testament.
Old man, old book, man. Long book. The Lord said he's coming in the volume of the book, volume being the whole thing.
Can I just say,
I saw 2%
of the book, right? destruction will be.
That's what the Bible is.
No, I mean Revelations.
Revelations is.
No, I mean Revelations is a destruction book.
You know the word revelation means to reveal.
Okay, no, I
it's all instruction.
I mean, obviously, yeah, but like, I mean, it's a destruction book.
Okay. Now, see, you're just saying revelation. No.
Assembly. Like, the assembly line for today's world.
Right.
It's an instruction book for, like, what's about to happen. Well, basically, nothing should, like, take you more than
he just talked about revelation.
Yeah, it means to reveal.
Something unknown revealed.
And it was only revealed at a specific time.
Did he just say blood? Oh, hell.
That's their law. That's what
uh-huh.
it is. I'm saying, though. Folly is set in great dignity. To each and every individual, man, their folly gets worse. One folly is worse than another one for this folly. It's worse and worse.
I forgot we had a truce. You still wild. They got it crazy. What's up?
What's up, Tracy? What you do to your hair?
Lie to yourself.
You know what?
What do you do with that? Do you pour it on there or do you drink it? It's like, nah. Nah, she's cool though. That's all the women do. I mean, they're all women.
They about to get it, man. They about to get it.
Every last one of our women are whore. Damn near. I don't know how many are not. I know most of them are.
My mom was. Oh no, I made sure that apparently having a son is still can they get cocked up?
Yeah, I got a scripture dealing with Israel though.
Hey, you dropped now.
You probably fucking all kinds of Edomites too. You probably specifically fuck Edomites. You know?
Edomites is white.
All these motherfucking niggas down here getting paid for suits and this shit.
Hey, you want me something?
They are no good, man.
Deuteronomy 32 and it's kind of long though, but it's
in my and Vera had to tell Najee to find you good, how you know what a good man is.
32.
Is if you see that man wearing a suit and a tie. My daughter corrected her not too long ago on that shit. She said to her a few years ago.
That's high. That's some Masonic shit.
You know what I mean?
You ain't gonna catch me dead wearing a tie.
Fucking suit and a suit
I
too.
I kind of need to.
What does a tie do for you? What does that do for you?
Well, apparently it makes you look more professional. Personally, though, I think it's just a decorated noose.
That's what it is. It's a noose. You're showing. You're pretty much showing that you and like when you become a Freemason, you gotta put a noose around your neck. With a heart, with a dagger to your heart, you know what I mean? A tie ain't no different than that, and it's also a phallic symbol, shaped like a penis, an uncircumcised penis.
People wear a tie, never question, what is a tie? What is a tie? What is
it? And they wear it, they just don't question it.
Since everyone else does. People are fucking sheep, man. They shit everybody else.
Yep. That's how they
call it. First thing you do when you get home, take that
fucking yeah,
no, I mean, like, 4 years ago, he should have died.
Deuteronomy 32:22, for fire is kindled in my anger, and shall burn it unto the lowest hell.
To the lowest hell. That's going to be the earth. All this shit's going to be burning up. Go ahead.
Shall consume the earth with her increase and set on fire at the foundation of the mountain.
Yeah, so the mountains represent the governments, like America, that great mighty mountain. Because the Bible calls empire mountain. You know what I'm saying? So America, the whole mountain of America is going to be destroyed.
Oh, come on. We all know that basically the mountain's actually the corporations.
Well, that too. I mean, that's who running shit.
I mean, it's not even the government anymore. It's just the corporations. It just basically switched from being in a mafia to being in a corporate office.
What that faggot say, man? I've been to the mountaintop.
Dude, he went to nothing. He went to hell.
Fuck that.
fact.
And he's part of the,
this is Black History Month too.
And he's part of the Boulay Society.
I mean, shit.
And he was a literal faggot. He was literally a faggot.
Wait, Malcolm X will tell you that. Wait till March. Wait till March. Not this month.
Man, it was boy, he couldn't even talk right. Every time he talked, it sounded like he was singing. You know what I mean? Humming and shit. Yeah, come on, bro. Get the fuck out of here. Don't know normal ass people talk like that. I mean, that's some fake ass shit. And he was a communist, homosexual, member of the Boulay Society.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Sigma 55.
Sickness.
He's a well-known communist.
Okay, yeah, cool. But like, what's wrong with being a communist?
A lot. That's part of the so-called Jew system, the New World Order system.
The Jews created every system.
Okay, and what about
they
capitalism?
They created every system. Yeah. They don't, where in the Constitution does it say capitalism?
It's a capitalist society.
What does capitalism mean? It means you get everything and fuck every man for himself. That's a system. That's a satanic system. And, so, and communism is a lie. They say it's there to help the community, but no, it's not.
It's I mean, it's a good concept.
Really,
it's,
capitalism?
It's been executed poorly.
Capitalism, communism, it's all the same shit. Control.
Socialism.
Whoa. Control. A system where they're in control and you ain't. That's what it is.
Okay, so what about anarchy?
Well, we don't believe in anarchy. Anarchy means no rule. We believe in the lords of the king.
That's a lawless society.
That's a lawless society. We ain't with that.
So technically, that goes straight to communism.
Nah. If you got to make up these fancy titles for everything, the Bible calls for a theocratic monarchy, which means one king from the tribe of Judah. But that's fantasy land. That's not going to happen. You know what I mean? That ain't going to happen until the Lord comes back. When the Lord comes back, then everything will be put back in its proper order.
Well, he may come back. The problem is...
Oh, you'll know when he comes back.
Would you really send your son to a... Lions.
Then a lion? Hell no. Who in their right mind would say?
Exactly. And right now, this entire planet is nothing but a single lion.
Pretty much.
So imagine him being born into a den of lions.
Yeah, actually, more like a
trained and raised to think like a den of lions.
More like a pit of snakes.
A pit of snakes.
I mean, technically, I'm using lions because lions will eat his ass up.
Yeah.
I'm talking about like with the media. Oh, Jesus is back. Like, you have it on the floor. You have it raised up.
Our people are lions, too. Man. The white man becomes a lion. They all need to be a lion.
What is the media?
Who
they going to ask about to have your people? You know, he's going to destroy
it. He's going to take it.
Everybody's going to be subdued under his
And what's that scripture that say that kingdom shall be taken by fools? Ain't that, I forget what that says. It's in the New Testament. The kingdom shall be taken by fools.
The saints shall take the kingdom.
That's what it is. It says
the saints
shall take the kingdom. Amen. Hey, let's finish up with that Deuteronomy. Because there's a whole lot of meat I want to get out there.
You can get a full meal.
Oh, shit, like I just got out of this discussion too.
You're on this 32 and I'm going to go back to 33. I will keep mischief upon those. I will
spend. Talking about, you know, this is what the Lord's going to do to our people.
I like you guys because, like, you guys are like, you're a black sheep reads the Bible.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
Like the people read, they just shout. And then, like, the people in the purple just, like, pass out fucking flyers and that's
right,
it.
Right, exactly. That's what I was trying to explain to dude. They already heard. You just sit there and listen. You'll see who, you'll know who got the truth and who don't.
I don't listen.
So motherfuckers don't come out here edifying nobody, man.
Hey, because they don't know they know nothing.
Right.
They ain't taught nothing.
They was right, bro. They ain't do. He never talked to a bitch. That's what I'm saying. I was just about that. Anybody can get it. They ain't doing
nothing. But you say you're Howard. That's why I'm calling on God. That's why I'm calling the name of the Lord and they're not.
That's right. That's right.
That's something they're going to have to deal with. Don't let me catch them, but I'm going to give them. The Lord will have me.
They're out here on Saturday.
Go ahead. We ain't worried about those guys. Saturdays?
I don't want it. You can't make me.
And you be out here all the time like that?
Hell yeah. This is my area.
You like being out here? roaming the streets.
I mean, yeah. Shit. That's the only real type of freedom I got. Or, like, the real illusion of freedom that I have.
For real, you might as well get outside and enjoy the air and shit, the polluted air.
That good polluted air that I'm trapped by, not to mention also like the police in my fucking spot.
Let's get back to that new rock.
There you go.
Oh, what you got?
This is Daniel 7:18. So 17. These great beasts, which are four kings which shall rise from out of the earth. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, ever, and ever.
Yeah, the saints shall take. That's a game.
You have a light.
That's the spirit. I thought it was the New Testament. Daniel is like the New Testament.
Let's get fired, but y'all ain't
got this. We got the light. We got lamps. Some oil.
I just need something to burn up all my possessions.
Only building the U.S. Bank.
With a red shield.
They're only handling the affairs in Columbus, man, in the suburbs.
And it has a red shield.
That's crazy.
Which means red shield in German is Rothschild.
Yep, yep.
So the Rothschilds own that bank. And that's Huntington right there. And what's Huntington symbol? A 6-point star. You know what I mean? So-called Jew, man. And molecular symbols. You know, if you know how to read symbols, you can see a symbol speak volume. You know what I mean?
TNT.
They go to Earth. They show you they control the Earth. That's what they showing you.
Satanic symbols.
That's another language. You gotta learn how to read symbols.
Or PNC, which is basically control, but not really exactly the right
way.
However, at the same time, PNC is right across the street from the White House in Washington, D.C.
Is it?
Yeah.
I mean, it's all owned by the same people. A small handful of people owning all those banks. Yeah, none of our people own them. You know anybody that owns a bank? Yeah, I don't even know motherfucker. Don't even own a hot dog park.
Right, for real.
Yeah, own a house. How many people you know actually own, paid off, owns that whole house?
I swear one day I'm going to bring my Bible down here and I'm going to start preaching. I don't have a Bible.
Get a digital Bible. That's why we used to have.
That's what I'm doing right now. Like, just trying to start.
We used to have a lot more people out here with us. Good. Man, it's not for it. It's not for it. Yeah, we all got to teach us the exact same thing. We can't all have our own side.
I heard that, bro. You didn't even know what I said. Here you go, Revelation 1 and 30. Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy and keep those things which are written therein for the time.
Yeah, you get blessed by reading. You know what I mean?
Say
a little prayer, go read. Lord will reveal something to you every time.
Hey, I have a Latin book. I have a Latin book.
Latin?
Yeah.
What you got? Sound like he holding. He's holding that some Latin.
Hey, I got a question for you.
Like me some Latin. Isn't it like a Latin dictionary?
Like dictionary
on
phrases.
Oh, that's good stuff to read. They got apps like that in the Play Store too you can get.
Yeah, I know, but like I don't really like trust that technology shit because it can always be altered. Even though I'm an IT, that doesn't mean I have to live life.
You say you really want to, I don't know if you're really serious about it. This is a little 14, like,
I can, I'm considering.
Check that out.
It's a heavy consideration.
Well, consider this. It's Luke 14 to 26. If any man come to me and hate not his father or mother or wife, he sees them today in his own life also. He cannot be my disciple.
You hear that? Read it again. Listen, man.
Luke 14 to 26. Any man comes to me.
Any man comes to you, you're a man, right? Okay.
And hate not his father, and mother, and wife, and children, and brethren, and sisters, yea, and his own life also.
Are you preparing your mind to tell your mom and dad that they doing wrong? It don't mean hate your mom. Hate your mom, you fucking bitch. It don't mean that. It means to dislike people when they're wicked.
Oh, you've heard the stories.
Oh, I know a lot, man. You know, but they don't mean to that. But you gotta honor your mother in your life, you know? But you gotta dislike people living in wickedness, man.
I just got a phone with my dad the other day. I told him that he was going to get
the in Chicago story.
Colorado. I don't understand how the fuck he got arrested for smoking weed in public.
That's Jake, and he does it for something stupid like that.
This is the cops who will get you regardless.
Usually cops are just stuck to throw that board out. Yeah. You know, but what is it?
In his own life also, he cannot be my disciple.
Like, you enjoy your life, man. You enjoy your life. Comfortable waking up every day with a smile on your face and getting served breakfast in bed.
And that's a luxury. You act like I have that type of luxury. No, I wake up not wanting to go nowhere, yet looking forward to at least working with some computers, because like then,
yeah, like you got something to look forward to that keep you busy.
That's some type of semblance, right. Like, I'm away from the computer. Like, when I talk to y'all, when I skateboard and when I'm at the computer, that's like my only like real high time. Other than that, not
fussing. See, the thing about wisdom, man, when you learn wisdom, you wake up and you find out, damn, I'm a slave. Damn, I'm being oppressed, you know? And then your sorrow, that shine start to, that expression on your face start to drop.
You know, and as scriptures say, a wise man scarcely smiles.
I swear the only thing is being the slave that knows that he is a slave and then, like, watches everyone else unaware that they're slaves. Or pretend like they know they're slaves, but they didn't know that they're slaves. That pisses me off.
Most times you got most people in the train. Most times
Yeah, I got something for that. Precept today. This is Ecclesiastes 7, and I'm gonna start at 2. You know, I'm gonna start at 1. A good name is better than precious ointment, and the day of death than the day of one's birth.
Yeah, death is better than being born. You be praying to the Lord, like, just let me find a way. Death's a good option. Give me that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like,
that's
the best option you can see out there sometimes.
It is better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of feasting. So it's best to seek out somebody that's in that sorrowful state of mind also, so y'all can relate. So they can be in that right state of mind, you know, condemned shit, you know?
If somebody's all happy, laughing all the time, something ain't right with it, man. Yeah. Ain't nothing to be happy about it.
It was like this girl named Maggie who went to my school. The very first day, like, she just showed up with a fucking smile on her.
Well, I mean, women.
I'm like, wipe that fucking smile off your face. There's nothing to smile about. You're at the Graham School. Congratulations, kids. I swear to God, like, she was always nice to other people. And then, like, she asked me all the time, like, why are you so mean to me? I'm like, how the fuck are you so happy? All the time.
He didn't know how to come at her, so he came in better.
I mean, women on average are so stupid, though. They're always happy. It's like a dog's happy. You see a dog come up, all dumb. They don't know what's going on. Tail wagging. That's a woman.
What the fuck? Is that a man or a woman?
I don't know.
Don't try to figure it out. But this one's really good that you can't tell you what.
Thank you.
That's what you call booty.
That's delicious.
What you think the Lord gonna give us when we take shit over?
That's delicious.
We're gonna get booty.
It's a booty.
Here we go. No, fuck the booty. I want titties.
He ain't gonna give us nothing. I know that.
There's only one person I really want in life. Pinky.
That's
Pinky?
She had AIDS.
I'm playing.
The porn star? I'm gonna cut her up all kind of on the internet, man. I used to stalk that bitch, man.
That bitch got AIDS.
Yeah, I used to kill her with the scriptures, man. Bitch had the nerve to say, only God can judge me. For real.
Wait, hold on. You actually know me?
No, I actually talked to her. On the internet. Pinky, the porn bitch.
Yeah. You can talk to all these famous people.
Yeah, you can. Like, back in the day when I was on Twitter. You gotta come out here and learn, man. Stop fooling around, bro. Because you're amongst brothers when you come across. You know, true brothers. Let me get back into this. It is better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of feasting, for that is the end of all men, and the living will lay it to his heart. Sorrow is better than laughter, for by the sadness of the countenance of the heart is made better. The heart of the wise is in the house of mourning.
All right, we're mourning that. We're not celebrating.
Am I reading scripture?
There ain't nothing to celebrate. What are we going to celebrate? By how they just took all my money?
Exactly.
How I got shit now?
There you go.
You know what I mean?
And all you're doing is speaking common sense.
And death.
Common fucking sense.
Because that's like the one thing that won't be taken away.
What's that?
Celebrating death, because that's the one thing that won't be taken away.
Yeah.
Unless the doctor's a bitch.
Yeah, really.
In that case.
Yeah, really, the end of the day, yeah, death really is. I ain't going to get that scripture, oh, death, where is thy sting?